Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous Kreos, aka Kreos the Ram Aries, the Titan god of heavenly constellations. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. Kreos was the Titan god of heavenly constellations and was also known as the Pillar of the South Pole. Kreos, which means Ram, was often referred as the starting season of the Greek year because his constellation was called Aries, which nowadays means the start of spring. Together with his other three brothers, Koios, Hyperion and Iapetus, they presided as the pillars of holding heaven and earth apart. He was one of six sons of Uranus and Gaia and is mentioned by Apollodorus as one of the five brothers, all but Okeanos, who participated in the rebellion against Uranus and later attacked him. When they overcame him, the four brothers probably held him down while Cronos castrated him. According to Pausanias, Kreos was the father of Python, a dragon slain by Apollo, and was also closely related with the island of Evia. The author even names two rivers after the Titan. In the time of war, aka the Titanomachy, he was mentioned siding with the Titans against the younger Olympian gods. After the war, where the Titans had lost, Kreos was along with his brothers and many relatives imprisoned in Tartarus beneath the underworld. Although there is no clear statement made, he was supposed to be condemned to eternal punishment. However, according to Aeschylus' Lost Play, he was later released by Zeus from Tartarus with the rest of the Titans. In his time, he consorted with his half-sister Evrivia, the daughter of Gaia and Pontus. Together they had three children, Astraeus, Titan god of the stars and the art of astrology. He was also the god of the dusk and father of the four winds and the stars of the heaven by Eos. They also had children who are often associated with the time of twilight. Pallas, Titan god of Warcraft, who was defeated during the Titanomachy by the younger goddess Athena. He was a father of rivalry, victory, strength and power. Perses, Titan god of destruction. He was married with his cousin Asteria, with whom he fathered Hecate. Kreos is a little known deity from Greek mythology. Today, most people think of Greek mythology as being focused on Zeus and the other gods of Mount Olympus, and the heroes of the same time period. According to Greek mythology though, there was a golden age before the Olympian gods, and it is from this time period when Kreos comes from. Kreos is said to have been one of the elder Titan gods, and appears in the list of 12 Titans as written down by Hesiod. Hesiod's Theogony is normally taken as the primary source for the genealogy, but Kreos also appears in other sources, including Apollodorus' Bibliotheca. The stories tell of how Kreos, his five brothers and six sisters, were born to Uranus and Gaia, and were collectively known as the Titans. Uranus was the supreme deity of this period, but Gaia encouraged the Titans to rebel against their father. Cronos was the only Titan willing to openly go against his father though, and so Gaia furnished him with a sickle to castrate Uranus with. As Uranus sank to Earth to make love to his partner, Kreos, who was stationed at the south corner of the world, grabbed hold of his father, Koios, Hyperion and Iapetus, who were positioned at the other three corners did likewise. As Uranus was held in place, Cronos struck. The four brothers who held the sky in place are often referred to as the pillars of Earth. For his actions, Cronos became the new supreme deity, but the other Titans took up prominent roles. Kreos became the god of knowledge and would also become closely linked to the constellations of the night sky. Indeed, Kreos is said to be the constellation Aries, as Kreos was the name given to that constellation by the ancient Greeks. Unlike most of the other Titans, Kreos was not partnered with one of his sisters and instead Evrivia, goddess of the mastery of the seas, was his wife. Kreos and Evrivia would have three sons, Astraeus, god of stars and planets, Pallas, god of Warcraft and Perses, god of destruction. Kreos and the other Titans would eventually fall from power. Just as Cronos had risen up against his father, so Zeus did likewise. Zeus and his siblings fought the Titans in a 10-year war that became known as the Titanomachy. Details of the fighting have been lost, but it is known that Kreos fought alongside his siblings, and so when the Titans were overthrown, he, like them, was cast into the prison pit of Tartarus. Whether this imprisonment was for all eternity or whether Zeus eventually released the Titans depends on which source is being read. Nevertheless, the roles that the Titans had once undertaken were taken over by the deities of Zeus period. Let us finish with the following saying. If you want to live a life without stress, consider whatever is going to happen in the future as if it has already happened. Epictetus. That being said, remember guys to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel, it would help us a lot. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.